storytelling is the best way to convey a message to your audience, whether it's in a classroom or it is on a YouTube channel. And the best way to do that is animation. Canva has helped us with creating animations. And one way that we're going to do this on this video is to find an app like Cartoonist that's going to create cartoons for us. And then we can animate them with the new animation that Canva has introduced in 2024. The Cartoonist app looks like this. It takes your imagination to the fantasy world. You create your own cartoons and then we're going to animate them. So we're going to use it in a new design and we're going to create a video cartoon so that we can find beautiful templates to use on our cartoon. And the Cartoonist app is open up. So we're going to create a princess. It says that we need to write a description of the cartoon that we want and we get 4 credits per day. So it's very important the way that you use your example. We want to create a African little princess with her cell phone and she's excited that it is in her hand. So you're going to write the description of your cartoon and then you click on generate image. And we generate image. The image is successfully created and it gets uploaded to your canvas. You can then size it and do as you wish. It is a beautiful 3D image that we've created. Then, of course, you will use the necessary prompts based on the type of cartoon you would like to create. Now we're going to generate the second image. All of your cartoons and you have all of them. What I want to showcase you in this video is the new animations that Canva has introduced in 2024. You're going to select the image and we've seen with Canva Create that this has changed. So for now, I'm still on the old one and when I have the new one, I will show you how to do that. But it's also very simple. It's so sophisticated. You will see when you get it. Let me stop babbling. You're going to select the image, you're going to click on animate, then you're going to scroll down. The new one is the blur animation and the other one is the succession animation. They're quite useful for animation in my point of view because if you want to tell a story like you want to tell a story on cartoons, you would select your blur. Say you have 3 panels. And you would like to animate the first image of the girl getting her cell phone and you choose blur, you could then either leave it as both, but we want to have the animation when the slide enters. So on enter, and then we can reduce the speed of the animation and it starts telling a story that way and it's smooth and it's crisp and it's beautiful and it blurs the image into the story. The other one I want to show you is the succession animation. So you're going to scroll down and you're going to click on succession and it zooms in depending on how fast you want it to be and how intense you want the succession to be and you want it on enter or on exit. So please take note that this, the speed as well as intensity are for Canva Pro users. You can't do this if you're on a free account, but you can always go trial it out using my link below. But it is just beautiful because it would zoom in and then you could tell your story with the cartoon and have your story go out like that. The last tip with video cartoon, because you've selected cartoon video on Canva, you can go to design and with design, you get all templates that you could use that can guide your cartoon and help you create the cartoon, and it's already animated, etc., etc. But it's going to help you better if you do pick a template that you want to use and you run with it. So that is also another option where you don't have to start from scratch. After you found the template that you like, you're going to click and open it. You will get different slides that are created that you could hover and you see how it looks like. You then decide which one you want to use and which one you don't want to use. So say we want to take the first one, you're going to click and edit to the first slide because that's the empty slide. And then we start giving the cartoon a name. I want to show you now one page that I'm going to create this beautiful cartoon, and then you can apply it to all of the pages based on the story that you would like to tell. So what is going to help you is if you go to your elements and you search for cartoon. So with your cartoon, it could be a cartoon video that you're going to be using. It could be a cartoon image or photo that you want to use in order for you to start creating a gorgeous looking cartoon. And I've scrolled down and I found this beautiful image that I can use for my 3D cartoon, because this cartoon of ours is 3D. So say we want and we found this image of this cartoon that we can use, this one. We're going to click and edit to our background and right click and set it as an image. The image of our little girl, we're going to select it, choose edit image, and then use our background remover to take off the background so that she is excited and standing over there. Next, we're going to press R for rectangle so that we can add the text of the story that we would like to tell. So I use ChatGPT, I use my own imagination. So it's up to you what kind of story you would like to tell, and you can write a little story of your animation. You can use your borders so that you have a border weight. It could have nice dashes, and you could change the color of your border to a white so that it looks stunning. And if you want it to be a little bit bigger, you can do that. It is just up to you. And if you want to add text now on there, you could write the story that I've copied. I've asked ChatGPT to create for me. And my story looks like this, a young girl, Zandile, and I edit on my cartoon box and I make it nice and big and it looks absolutely stunning. Maybe we want the corners to be a bit rounded for that cartoon effect. And then you could carry on like this, telling your story, making sure that you have added your animation on your cartoon. You are also using transition between your pages so that it looks nice. So let me show you the end results of this cartoon. Thank you. And then you can let me know in the comments below if this has added value. Please share it with any other designer that this could help. You could also go and access our Canva course at Udemy. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on our next video.